Hey there guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman, I'm a game developer. Today we're going to create a Falling Dots game. So we're gonna make up this as we go, except for the graphics. Put a counter here and two dots and a dot with two directions. And a block here to generate the dots. Now again, this is going to be a mobile game for a tablet or a cell phone or anything really. We're gonna turn these two objects into bouncing balls. Let me set the speed to 40. This object here, we're gonna make it a path object. We're gonna set the speed to super high, loop movement, and reverse at the end. Two dots, we don't wanna create them at start. I'm gonna make an always. These two dots always look in the direction of the green dot. The orange too. The condition, use the timer, use calculation, random range. Set this set to maybe 600 milliseconds to 1500. Let's make a counter first. Clone these. Let's call this counter random. I'm gonna paint this at purple. If the counter is set to zero, we're gonna generate one of the green dots relative to the red block. Try it out. Fine. But I should be looking at the green dot, the bigger green dot. Seems to work fine. Collision between the green dot and the smaller green dot will destroy the green dot. But this is only going to work if the bigger green dot is facing right. If it's facing left, we are going to destroy everything. Can even show a graphic. Maybe I can make the font bigger. Red, because when you get game over, red should show up. And the initial paragraph is going to be blank. So if we get game over, this is going to show up. Select paragraph, paragraph two. Green, 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 green. Okay, we're only going green now. So if this counter is set to one, we're going to produce a orange dot relative to the red dot or red square. Now we need a way to randomize this counter. Let's say every 3 milliseconds, set this counter to random range between 0 and 1. From 0 and 1, whoa, that's coming too fast. Down this to 800, maybe 19. Now if the user clicks anywhere on the screen or taps on the screen, let's clone this counter again. Give it an icon. I call this one direction. And let's make this green. We're gonna make this blue. So if the user clicks anywhere on the screen, taps on the screen, to add one to this counter, if the counter is greater than one, then we set it back to zero. If the counter is zero, we set our green dot's direction to right. And if the counter is equal to 1, you can set the direction to left. This has to be greater, not equals. You can see that we can change the counter. Okay, game over. Let's try it out. Let's copy line 4 and 5. You can probably organize this after better. Collision between the big dot and the orange dot. In that case, we're going to destroy the orange dot. And for facing left, we're going to destroy everything and display paragraph 2. Green, 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 orange. Oh, wait a second. Okay, all right, so this has to be facing left, and this has to be facing right. It's the opposite. Let's try it out. Green, orange. Orange. Okay, so I'm going to try to lose now. So I'm going to set this to orange, and we should get game over. I'm going to do it the other way around. Game over. That works fine. Orange, game over. So, so every time this happens, we are going to add one to the score. Game over already. This is impossible. Okay, try it out. Green, orange, green, orange, green, orange, orange. Oh, I got me. Oh. If you liked this video, hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first and top comment. And our top comment is GhostKiller231. Again.
As high as I can to champ, which is the new melee weapon, which I really want. Get out there
and
get the win.
And our first comment is Essential Horrors.